You're watching Electrical Engineering Lectures channel. For more videos, please do like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications.
Welcome to another video. In the last video, I have shown you how to read the digital input and we have also discussed the debouncing effect. In this video, I am going to show you how to interface alphanumeric LCD with PIC microcontrollers using C programming. So in this video, I'm going to play with different commands of PICC compiler to print the different characters on different locations of LCD. And then I'm also to tell you how to use the printf syntax to display different types of data types on the LCD. So let's just go to the brief overview of LCD. Since we are using alphanumeric LCD, so it is a liquid crystal display with the purpose of displaying characters, that is letters or numbers. And the most common sizes of this LCD are 16x2 and 16x4. It means that they have either two rows or four rows of 16 characters each. And for controlling the LCD, there is 4-bit data bus and 3 control pins. So we have to use 7 pins of microcontroller in order to interface with this LCD. So here is the description of the LCD. We have used two models, two most common models of LCD, which is 16x4, which has 4 rows of 16 characters each. So this is the LCD pin layout. You can see that there are 16 pins of these LCD. The first is the VSS, which is 0 volt. The second pin is VDD, which is mostly 5 volt. The third is V0, which is used for the contrast of the LCD, and we normally insert a resistor with the ground to connect with this pin and change the value of the resistor in order to set the contrast of the LCD. Fourth is the RS, which is a reset pin, and this one is the control pin. Next is RW, which is read write, and this is also a control pin. E is the enable pin, which is another control pin, so we have 3 control pins of this LCD. Then comes the data pins. We are using only 4 data pins to interface the LCD. So we will connect DB4 to DB7 with our PIC microcontroller. Finally, LED plus is on the 5 volt. For the backlight, we normally insert a resistor of 330 ohms in order to avoid burning of the LCD. And LED minus will be connected to the ground. So this is a LCD pin layout. So after having a brief overview of the LCD, now it's time to write our program to interface the LCD. So moving on to write our C program in the PICC compiler. Again, the first command will always be to include the device header file. The next is to include math.h, which handles any mathematical operation that you will be using in the program. And the next command is fuses. Again, I have told you about these fuses in my previous videos. Since I am using 4 MHz, so this hash use delay is to include the 4 MHz oscillator. To interface the LCD, we will be going to use a built-in file of PICC compiler, which is lcd.c. So we have to include this file. So let us just go into the detail of this file. Right-click this file and select Open File at Cursor. You can now see the detail of this file. Here you can see the pin connection of LCD with microcontroller. That D0 of the microcontroller will be connected to enable pin, D1 will be connected to RS, and so on for all the pins of microcontroller. Remember that this driver is basically for the 40 pin microcontroller which have port D. And port D will be used to interface the LCD. If you are going to use 28-pin microcontroller, then you have to rewrite this or modify this driver. So getting back over main program, just ignore this initialization of variables. Also in this driver file, you can see that there are mainly 4 functions to control the LCD. The first one is the LCD underscore init, which is used for initialization of the LCD, and it must be called before any other function in the main function. Another function is LCD underscore put CC, and this will display the C on the next position of LCD. You can also use backslash F in place of C to clear the complete display of LCD. The most important command is the LCD underscore go to XY X.C. It will print the character on X and Y coordinates of the LCD. And finally, LCD underscore get C XY. This command will return the character at position which is printed at the position X and Y on the LCD. So after including the main driver file, which is lcd.c, then comes our main function, which is void main. We have to initialize the LCD by using a built-in function lcd underscore init. So afterwards, we'll be entering into our infinite while loop. Then I'm going to use lcd underscore go to xy 1.1, and I will print a string, which is, this is my first program on the LCD. So what this command will do, this will print the whole string starting from first row and first column, and then it will continue to print the complete string on the third row. So if I compile this program, and we'll check the output on the Proteus. I've already drawn a schematic where I'm using PIC16F877A, which is the most common microcontroller. And I'm using 16x4 LCD, which has 4 rows of 16 character each. The connection of microcontroller and the LCD is according to what is written in the driver, that I have connected pin D0 with enable, pin D1 with read and write, and so on for all the pins. And I am using only 4 data pins. So let us simulate this. So here you can see that it is written on the LCD. Since this is my first program, is greater than 16 characters, that's why the remaining line is printed on the third row. Basically, 1 and 3rd row are connected with each other, and 2 and 4 row are connected with each other. So the remaining part of 1st row will be printed on the 3rd row. And similarly, if you print the same string on the 2nd row, the remaining part will print on the 4th row. So moving back to our main program, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to comment this command. And uncomment these commands. So if you want to print the whole string in first two rows, then you have to use lcd go to xy 1.1 and print this is my first in the first row, and then this is for the command to print into the second row. That is first column and second row, and you're going to print program on the second row. So if I build this program, play the simulation. Now you can see that this is my first is written in the first row and program in the second row. This is how to print the characters in different rows of LCD. So the next thing is, if you want to print in the third and fourth row, what you are going to do, I'm going to uncomment these 5 commands. So I have used lcd go to xy 17x1. 17 means that it will print the string in the third row, 17, 1, and 17, 2 means that it will print the string in the fourth row. And I've inserted an additional intentional delay of 5 seconds. Now you will see the string will be written in all four lines of the LCD. Here you can see that it is written in all four lines. So this is how you can print any string or any character in any line of the LCD. Now if you want to clear the display, you have to use this command, which is, again, it will be written in the printf section. So printf lcd underscore putc, and you will be using backslash f to clear the display. Again, I've used this delay so that you can easily see that the whole display will be clear from the LCD. So I'm going to play the simulation again. You can see that all four lines are written on the LCD, and after some time, the complete LCD will be clear, as you can see here. So getting back to our main program, now I will show you how to use the syntax of printf command to display different data types variable. So first of all, I'm going to display a int 8 or 8 bit variable on the screen. So after the flash of the screen, it will display a variable a whose value is initialized at the start of the program, which is equal to 20. So you will see a equal to 20 on the LCD. So what I have done, I've used printf command, and this command I've written lcd underscore putc, then use comma, then invert. I've written a equal to, this is a string inside the inverted commas, this is percentage u to display a 8 bit variable. This percentage u is special character of PICC. This will not appear as a string, rather it will display a int 8 variable on the screen. So this is how you can use to print the variable. So I have to insert a delay of 5 seconds. So I'm going to reduce this delay so the program will run quickly. Now after a flash, you can see that it is written a equal to 20. Similarly, if you want to display int 16 variable, then what I'm going to do, I'm going to use again printf, and instead of percentage u, this time I'm going to use percentage lu for long integer, which is of 16 bits. I've initialized b of data type 16, and this is equal to 3500. So this command will print 3500 on the screen. Similarly, to print a float value, instead of using percentage LU, this time I'm going to use 2.1F, where F is used to display a float value, since C is initialized as float variable whose value is equal to 32.656. So this is a command to print a float variable, and 0.1 means that it will display one decimal place. I'm going to build this command. The whole program will be repeating in the same sequence. After the flash, a equal to 20, then B equal to 3500 and afterwards C equal to 32.6. Only the one decimal place is displayed on the LCD. So finally, what I'm going to do, I'm going to print all these three data types in the same command. So how I'm going to do this? I will again clear the display by using the same command, which is lcdputc and backslash f in the inverted commas. So what this command will do, it will display the value of A, B and C starting from first row and first column. So how you are going to display all these three data types in same command in the inverted commas, A equal to, this is again a string, then use the same special character percentage U after the desired space, then B equal to, this is again a string, then you put percentage LU, and similarly for the float variable you will use percentage 2.1F, then comma, then you have to write the variable name in the same sequence as you have written the special character of this variable in the inverted comma. So first of all, I have used int 8, so I write A, then B, and then C. So what will this command do? This will print all these three variables in the same line. So I'm going to run this and play the simulation. Now the whole program will again run in the same sequence. Here you go, A equal to 20. It will display all three variables and then the whole display will be cleared. And you can see all three variables at the same time. So this is all from this video. In the next video, I'm going to tell you how to read the analog signals and how to display this analog value onto the LCD. So keep watching and do subscribe to this channel.